Now we're going to work on an investment problem. You have $12,000 to invest and three different funds from which to choose. The municipal bond fund has a 7% return, the local bank CDs have an 8% return, and the high-risk account has an expected, or hoped-for, return of 12%. To minimize risk, we decide not to invest any more than $2,000 in the high-risk account. For tax reasons, you need to invest at least three times as much in the municipal bonds as in the bank CDs. Assuming the year-end yields are as expected, what is the optimal investment amounts? So again, the first thing we're going to do is identify the variables. We're going to say B is the amount we invest in the bonds, C is the amount we invest in the CDs, and H is the amount invested in the high-risk account. Our objective function, what we want to do is we want to maximize our revenue. In order to maximize our revenue, we're going to take 7% times the amount invested in bonds, 8% times the amount invested in the CDs, and 12% times the amount invested in the high risk. Subject to the total available is the bond, the amount invested in bonds, CDs, and the high risk has to be less than or equal to $12,000. It says that we have to invest less than, we want to invest, you wouldn't decide to invest less than $2,000 in high risk. The tax requirements to invest at least three times as much in municipals as CDs. So bonds has to be greater than or equal to three times the amount invested in CDs. Since we want our variables all on the left-hand side of the inequality, we subtract 3C from both sides. So B minus 3C has to be greater than or equal to zero. Again, all the variables, the B, the C, and the H, have to be positive numbers, so we make them greater than or equal to zero. Setting this up, we initialize the values of zeros for all of our variables. The amount invested in the bonds, the CDs, and the high risk has to be no less than zero. We put in the 7%, the 8%, and the 12%, which are the returns for these investments. We put the amount for the bonds, the CDs, the high risk has to be great, less than or equal to $12,000. High risk, that's one, has to be less than or equal to $2,000. The amount in bonds, that's one, minus three times C, zero for the high risk, has to be greater than or equal to zero. Bonds has to be greater than or equal to zero. CDs is greater than or equal to zero. And high risk has to be greater than or equal to zero. Now we're going to set up our equations in order to evaluate the algebraic expressions. So again, we have that the 7% times the amount invested in bonds, and we want that to be a fixed cell so we can copy it to the constraints, plus the return on the CDs, which is the 8% times the amount invested in CDs. And again, we go to make that a fixed cell. And lastly, the 12% times the amount invested in the high risk, again, which is zero. And again, we want that to be a fixed cell. We notice that that is zero. And then we're going to copy this down. And we want to make sure that it's correct. So we click on the cell and we notice we have 1 times 0, 1 times 0, 1 times 0, which is what we want. We'll try one more, and we have 1 times 0, negative 3 times 0, and 0 times 0, so it looks like it's correct. Now we're going to go to data, and we're going to open up Solver in order to be able to determine how we're going to solve this particular system of inequality equations. Where it says set objective, we click on cell K14, because that is where we evaluated the objective function. It goes automatically to maximize, and we want to maximize the values associated with the amount we put in the bonds, the CDs, and the high-risk funds. And make sure you're in the correct window, so let's do that again. The objective function is in cell K14. We're maximizing. Go to the window for the B, C, and H. That's the zeros, and we have subject to our constraints. Now looking at the constraints, we have the information over here. that we are going to add the constraints. So we're going to add the constraint for the total amount invested, where we have zero has to be less than or equal to the $12,000. We add the high risk constraint, which says zero has to be less than or equal to the $2,000. We add the tax requirement constraint, which says zero has to be greater than or equal to the zero that we had there. We add the constraints for the trivial constraints. So we have that the B has to be greater than or equal to zero. We add the C, again, has to be greater than or equal to zero. Let's put the box over there. And lastly, we want to make sure that we have the H. All right, and I want to make sure that it's in the right place. So I have the 20, and this should also be 20. And lastly, we want the H to be greater than or equal to, let's get that correct, greater than or equal to, again, zero. And we finished, we press OK. Now I want to watch to make sure that I did everything correctly. So I have the K on the left-hand side of the inequality. I have the J on the right-hand side. And we have rows 16 and 17 are less than or equal to. Everything else should be greater than or equal to. I notice that 20, I have the wrong sign. So I click on here. I change it. And I'm just going to change the sign to greater than or equal to. I press OK. Now all the constraints look correct. I go to Simplex. I ask it to solve the equation. And we are noticing that we should invest $7,500 in municipal bonds, $2,500 in CDs, and $2,000 in the high-risk account for the maximum return or profit of $965.